Hello, I'm Melanie, a pediatric occupational therapist with Alberta Health Services. In the other videos in this series, you learn that the brain needs sensation. This sensation helps the brain know what's happening inside and outside the body. The brain takes in sensation through the five external senses and three internal senses, then processes that input. Sensory processing is a constant loop and happens very fast in the brain. Once sensation is processed, the brain responds with an emotional reaction, a physical action, or both. The amount of sensation needed for your child's brain to register it depends on their sensory threshold. This is unique to each person. These concepts were covered in more detail in other videos in this series. There's one more part to understanding how your child reacts to sensations. Habituation is how people can get used to a sensation and stop noticing it. There's constant sensory input coming into the eight senses. The brain can't pay attention to all of it. This would take up too much energy and would be exhausting. Fortunately, your child's brain has learned to be efficient. With familiar sensations, your child's brain learns to habituate. It becomes used to the sensations and just accepts that it's there. This means your child doesn't notice the sensation unless something changes with it or they choose to focus on it. When sensation becomes part of the background, it doesn't fill up their cup or activate their sensory threshold. Your child's threshold for a specific sensation can affect their ability to habituate or get used to a sensation. If your child has a low threshold for a sensation, it can be harder for their brain to habituate or get used to it. Small changes in the sensation alert your child's brain to pay attention to it. Their cup starts to fill up. Their sensory threshold is activated, and their brain responds. A common example is the sensation of clothing tags against your child's skin. The sensation of a tag is light touch. If your child has a lower threshold for light touch, it may be harder for their brain to habituate or get used to the tag. Once their brain does get used to the sensation, small changes to how it feels can alert their brain to pay attention again. The constant noticing of the tag takes a lot of energy and can become frustrating. If your child has a higher threshold for a sensation and their brain habituates to it, it's easy to miss important changes to that sensation. It takes a big change in the sensation to fill up the cup or activate the sensory threshold. Without enough sensation to activate the threshold, their brain doesn't respond to it. An example of this is tuning out voices. If your child has a higher threshold for sound, it can be easier to habituate to background noise. This is fine, except when you're trying to get their attention. To get their attention, you may need to call your child's name multiple times, or add in another sensation like touch so they notice the sound. Habituation is the brain being efficient. It helps keep your child's brain from getting overwhelmed processing every sensation. When the brain is overwhelmed with sensation, it's called sensory overload. Please watch the next video in this series to learn about sensory overload.
Find information, support, and services for you and your child by clicking on the link in the description.